Moving on to the wave equation. So do you guys see how it's similar, except the derivative is the second derivative? What does this describe? Well, we've talked about this a little bit before, but let me remind you. It's kind of like the temperature, excuse me, the heat equation, but with overshoot. And I'll explain what I mean by that. This kind of tells you that velocity, the rate of change, is proportional to the Laplacian. And this one says that acceleration is proportional to the Laplacian. You guys are with me on that? So when acceleration is proportional to the Laplacian, the function will start going to the place where Laplacian is zero. That's where it wants to go. It wants to go to the equilibrium. But when it reaches the equilibrium, by the time it reaches the equilibrium, it will have picked up some speed. And so it'll overshoot it and go as far, perhaps, to the other side. And then it'll say, oh, now I've overshot the Laplacian. Now the whole relationship is inverted. I used to be higher than all of my neighbors. Now I'm lower than all of my neighbors. And it'll start bringing you back. Acceleration will reverse. It reverses as soon as you pass through the equilibrium. And then you'll come back. And so that's why you get life. That's why the second derivative gives motion and therefore life. You overshoot the equilibrium and you come back and you begin to oscillate, which you can never do here because this tells you the velocity. The velocity's degree is proportional to the degree by which you deviate from the equilibrium. So the closer you get to the equilibrium, the slower you go. And so you never really reach it. It's sort of like exponential decay, as you will see. And this is all about overshooting and therefore coming back and creating this wave, oscillation. And so this is called the wave equation. Once again, I'm not going to write it down. So that's why the wave equation looks like this. And we've postulated it for guitar strings. And in this case, you will think of drums. Because a drum is like a two-dimensional string. And why does it sound so much worse? How come when you pluck a guitar, it just has this beautiful tone that lasts? And when you hit a drum, it just goes, psh. Okay, I will use a better sound effect in the video. You know, why is it so much different? Do we have the answer to that? Yes, we do. PDEs, these simple PDEs, will hold the answer to that. Wave equation. Let's talk about its initial and boundary conditions. Think of a drum. Well, you certainly need to know its shape and what happens at the boundary. So you once again need to know all of the values of the function at the boundary. Or if the drum is moving. But that's prescribing the value at the boundary. You can't just say, I don't know. You have to know where it is, but you can't say, I don't know what the function does on the boundary. No, that won't be enough to really specify the evolution of the drum. So you need to know the boundary, and you, of course, need to know where you start. And this is where the ODE analogy will be perfect, because where you start here is not enough. This is, again, an evolution. But it's a second-order evolution. You're given not the velocity, but the acceleration. The ODE analogy is U double prime equals U. You need two conditions here. You need to know the initial position and how fast you're moving. If you think of it as an evolution that you march through, then that's what you'll need to know. It won't be enough to know the initial position. You will also need to know how fast it's moving, its rate of change at the initial moment. Makes intuitive sense by analogy with ODEs? I think it does. So yes, from the point of view of, at least I have an idea on how to start, the wave equation is simpler than Laplace's equation, which is sort of as this simultaneous snapshot you've got to satisfy. Here you start somewhere, you have this additional piece of information for velocity, and then you know how to treasure hunt your way along. Maybe it's easy, maybe it's not, but at least you know what's going on. So wave equation. All of the phenomena associated with vibrations ultimately come down to the wave equation. Everything vibrates. The glass, the bridge, the table, the ruler, the straight edge, the chalk, your body to a degree, drums, musical instruments, elastic bodies, plastic bodies, metal bodies. everything vibrates. Currents. So whenever there is this phenomenon that describes, that entails going to the equilibrium, but of course overshooting it, because guess what? Inertia is one of the most fundamental facts of life, even if it wasn't recognized for 3,000 years as such. You know, but whenever there's inertia and then a restoring force, and somehow you have a sense that energy is conserved if you let it be, then wave equation plays a role. If a system is all about relaxation, slow relaxation to where it wants to go, then it's a heat equation. And if finally you want to describe that geometric final relaxed state, it's Laplace's equation. And if there is something that doesn't let it be relaxed persistently, then it's Poisson's equation. And these three equations basically describe, I don't want to say most of the natural phenomena, but there's always an element in any natural phenomenon that somehow corresponds to one of these behaviors.